So you did that yourself, huh?
Yep, sure did.
Looks like it holds a lot of stuff.
Holds about 500 pounds.
How'd you know how to do all that?
It's just pure instinct. Look, I don't need some know-it-all coming at me.
Hey, here's my hammer.
There's the wrong way to do things, and then there's the right way to do things. Hi, I'm Chase Rayburn with Gardner Denver's Pump University, and we at Gardner Denver believe in doing things the right way. So let's talk about packing installation. First thing you have to remember is lubricate every ring before putting it in with oil. The first ring that goes in is the junk ring. The junk ring has a shouldered edge on the inside, which faces towards the inside of the fluid end. The next ring is what we call the header ring. The header ring is a thick black ring that has a flat edge towards the back that faces towards the inside of the fluid end. Next are the two pressure rings. Install these rings one at a time and make sure you bring your elbow grease for this ring. It's a lot harder to put in because this is what seals in the pressure inside the fluid end. The second pressure ring fits in the same way and it goes in just as hard. The last ring that we're gonna put in is the lantern ring, or more commonly known as the brass ring. The holes on the lantern ring go into the fluid end first. This is where the packing lubrication filters through so that it can lubricate the plunger and the packing. Gardner Denver puts an O-ring on its brass and the wiper seal on the inside of the brass. The wiper seal has a lip which faces towards the inside of the fluid end so that the packing grease doesn't get splattered all over the power end. Other fluid end models and manufacturers' models don't have the same configuration as this fluid end does here. So make sure you refer to all manufacturer installation procedures to get the correct packing order. This is how we would suggest installing packing in the fluid end. We also have a few tips that we've gathered from our field experience on better ways to get the longest life out of your packing. First, proper cleaning. Always make sure to clean the inside of the fluid end and your packing before installing. You don't want the abrasive material left over from fracking to ruin the packing before it even begins. Second, always check your lubrication lines. Clogged up lubrication lines could lead to no lubrication inside the packing, which could cause the packing to burn up. Third, hand installation. I know it's a lot harder to install the packing into the fluid end by hand, but it really eliminates the possibility of destroying the packing when you just use your hand to put it in. Fourth and finally, packing nuts. We understand there is an issue with packing nuts becoming stuck. Always make sure that you don't over-tighten the packing nuts and you also clean the threads prior to packing nut installation. Thanks for watching our packing installation video. For more information, please visit pumpingperfected.com.